no.
Fuck. Oh, you got no gloves?
Oh, I got gloves.
Oh, shit. That bitch looked at us like we was crazy.
We are crazy.
Damn, you drop a glove out here?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you gotta be crazy to be coming out here, man. But we are, we're nuts. We're loco. We're fucking insane.
That's right. This is required, too.
This is required. Just cause it's fucking cold. You can't take a... Boss, I'm taking the day off. You can't go to your boss. We can't go to the Most High. Be like, Most High, you know, it's cold out there. You know, can we take a day off? That ain't working out. Can we have comp time? You know, you work so long, take comp time, vacation time. No. Your comp time, you're going to get sent to the spirit world. The vital way you take, stop doing this work.
I know, because this winter took forever to show up.
It sure did.
All of a sudden, it wanted to be winter time. What you got?
This is a Malachi 4:1.
Oh, yeah.
For behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven.
It's going to burn. Yeah, right, it's cold now, so it's going to be hot. All right, the day coming is going to burn as an oven. And we already see what just happened in Ukraine. Over there in Ukraine, the Russians just shot a goddamn nuke and scared the shit out the United States and the Europe with it. They try to say a chemical plant blew up. Man, that was a motherfucking nuke.
Mm-hmm.
That was a guy. Where's the videos on YouTube? You can watch it. It's a goddamn mushroom cloud.
You stay on right.
It took out the everyone's electrical system. Everybody's electric and all their electronics don't work.
Had all the characteristics of a nuke, just like you said, knock people electric grid off. And yep. Plus, that bomb, the camera was recording it from a distance, and after a while, the camera started shaking because of the aftershock.
That was a nuke.
Yep. Hell yeah, it was a fucking nuke.
All the
nuke.
Reports coming from Ukraine said it was a nuke. And then the mainstream media didn't cover it. If the mainstream media ain't talking about it, you know for goddamn sure that was a nuke.
That's right.
They don't want y'all to know about it.
For behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly.
Yeah, because that was just a miniature nuke, too. Just wait till the Russians start shooting those real nukes. They start shooting them star bombs.
Woo!
And what's that? Them Iskander missiles.
Them Iskanders.
The ICBMs.
Right, them Topol M's.
That's going to make that look like a firecracker.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like a sparkler.
Yeah, and that was a small one, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was a small one.
Mm-hmm.
Tactical. Tactical nuke.
Yeah.
Read that again, man.
For behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly, shall be stubble.
So all these fools out here, they out here calling themselves an atheist, agnostic, you know what I'm saying? They don't care about the Most High. They ain't keeping the laws of the Most High. They out here committing adultery. Women leaving their husbands, you know what I'm saying? Breaking up their families. They gonna be stubble, man.
Woo!
Because the Lord said this is a wicked and adulterous generation.
Mm-hmm.
That's the number one crime out here is adultery. Mm. Women being hoes.
Dressed like hoes.
Dressed like hoes. Looking like hoes.
Yeah, I met this bitch, man. This bitch got three kids, three different baby daddies, and she ain't with none of the daddies. From Atlanta, she moved here to Loma. She ain't with none of the daddies.
Look at this for a second.
Fucking nasty hoes, man. It's no answer. I mean, there's no... I mean, the only solution to curing this problem, since the people ain't got no, they don't have the means to judge the society in a righteous manner, the only solution to this problem is for these motherfuckers to be burnt the fuck up.
The only solution is death.
That's
destruction,
right.
Fire.
That's right. Shit. The people ain't in a position mentally to judge things righteously.
Hello? Everything you see on TV is all about adultery. Like I said, right before we came out, I was watching a Family Feud with Steve Harvey. And all the questions were about adultery. All the questions were about sex. Like I told you, they asked that question. They said, how did that go? You know how they ask questions on Family Feud? They said, what are things that you take out of a human's body? And this white bitch on there, she said a gerbil.
Wow.
A gerbil. So the first thing on this bitch's mind was the gerbils being stuck up in her asshole. She's probably sticking gerbils up in her husband's ass.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Just like, was that on campus? Was that here on this campus?
Eel.
When they sticking eels up each other's ass?
Right down there, right there.
Someone, they stuck eels up each other's asshole. Somebody died from it.
Yep. Right there where the sorority, that main street where the sorority is, and it's at the end of that street. Nasty. sexy ass motherfuckers. But that's how Patrick Swayze, that was one of his pastimes, favorite pastimes.
Richard Gere, too.
Richard Gere, yeah, yeah.
That, Richard Gere is famous for sticking gerbils up his ass.
It's a fucking sick ass society, man. Oh, this, God bless America, though.
Oh, yeah, fuck, goddamn America.
God bless America. I can blow my nose, bro.
I feel you, man.
This gonna be a continuing thing.
Yeah, I just do the snot rockets. Oh, there it is. Good. Damn.
Like the elements. Let me finish with this.
I got a scripture for the back grip.
I ain't finished with it, hold on.
Oh, go ahead. I'll get this next.
Okay, and all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble, and the day that cometh shall burn them up, said the Lord of hosts.
So yeah, that nuclear fire, that's gonna burn you faggots up, man. Y'all ain't gonna be ready for it either. Y'all living your little happy lives, you all comfortable. You know, especially in the wintertime, y'all can never withstand the elements. Y'all just up cozy. You got your thermostat turned on to 80 right now. You know what I'm saying?
Little, right, living toasty, yeah.
Living toasty.
Mm-hmm. Drinking hot cocoa.
Walking around in shorts in the wintertime. Drinking, yeah, hot cocoa.
With a ham sandwich, ham and cheese sandwich.
Eat some fried bacon and eggs. Some swine's flesh.
Oh, yeah, bacon, ham, and cheese sandwich. That's their pay favorite shit.
Yeah, they put bacon on ham.
Yeah.
We have some foul people, man.
Stupid.
It's a foul, wicked society. We hate it. We pray the Lord destroys this shit.
That's why we out here.
You got anything else?
That was it.
We read this Revelation 18 now. Revelation 18 and 21. And a mighty angel took up a stone like a great millstone and cast it into the sea, saying, thus with violence shall that great city Babylon be thrown down.
Boom!
And shall be found no more at all. So to say it right, so just like a great millstone. That millstone, that's the missiles, man. The Most High gonna hit this bitch with missiles.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he gonna put the spirit on them Russians to shoot all them ICBM thermonuclear missiles on America, and America's gonna be destroyed.
Burnt the fuck up.
Alright, I like this part too. And the voice of the harpers and musicians and the pipers and trumpeters shall be heard no more at all in thee. Like, why you go down High Street, you hear all that music bumping up in the clubs. All them clubs, that's something but a hot spot of adultery. You know what I'm saying? Just a cesspool of filth and vomit. You know what I'm saying? Abominations. All these clubs is nothing but adultery. This whole goddamn country is nothing but adultery, man. It's a wicked and adulterous generation. The Most High is going to destroy all you faggots. All you adulterous women, you're going to be destroyed. Your little demon, little children from your five different babies' daddies, they all going to die. They're going to get burnt up. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to laugh, man. We're going to celebrate. Just like we celebrated when that explosion happened in Ukraine. Laugh, man.
First thing came to my mind, I was like, oh shit, this shit is escalating.
That's why they just came out of those peace talks today. Was that today?
Mm-hmm. I was watching this shit all day yesterday and today, man. You know how they got the updates.
Yeah, they pretty much begging Putin don't do that.
Mm-hmm. I saw Putin coming out the meeting, they was all walking together. He had a snicker on his face.
Right, because he had the upper hand.
Yeah.
He coming out, he up in there boss hogging on them
damn
bitches,
right,
man.
You're
Obama
damn right.
Looked like a bitch compared to Putin.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Look like a little weak little faggot.
Proud look on his face and shit. Proud fucking.
Yeah, because Putin got that proud look. He does. He look like right. He came out there like he was victorious. and Russia don't give a goddamn about your peace talks and your treaties. They don't give a damn about your treaties. And why should he respect your treaties? America didn't respect their treaties with the North American Indians. Or any other treaty they made.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You got a precept, you got something to bring up, bring it out. Hey, your pocket got jacked up. As long as you got it. Who's the rest of it?
For real?
That's alright.
Second Ezra 16:11. The Lord shall threaten, who shall not be utterly bitten, beaten to powder at his presence.
Yeah, so y'all gonna be beaten to powder. How do you beat somebody to powder? What do you think this goddamn thermonuclear missile gonna do to you? Just gonna pulverize you. You're gonna be disintegrated, man.
Who was that up?
Read that again, man.
I was thinking of 13, because that's simple. I'll get it.
That whole second Ezra is nothing but prophecy of destruction.
Ezra had a hell of a spirit on him.
Right, because you don't even know what to read and say. You might as well read the whole book.
The whole thing.
Go ahead, read that again, man. That's a powerful scripture.
2 Ezra 16:11. The Lord shall threaten, and who shall not be utterly beaten to powder at his presence.
Right. Plus, some chariots is going to come out of the sky, too.
Shooting lasers and shit.
Shooting laser beams, and they shooting shit you don't know what it is. Mm-hmm. So the destruction you ain't never seen.
Can't comprehend it.
You can't comprehend it, exactly. They'll destroy you with a sound beam or something miraculous. Some heavenly fire. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Keep going.
The earth quaketh in the foundation thereof. The sea ariseth up with waves from the deep.
All right, so when the missiles start hitting, when the missiles hit, they're going to shoot some of those missiles right off the coast. It's going to cause tsunamis. They're going to be tsunamis. A tsunami going to overtake goddamn New York City. They're going to get hit by a tsunami of water and a tsunami of fire.
Yeah, massive earthquakes and
massive
shit.
Massive earthquakes.
Yep.
Oh, shit. Old Faithful, they said, might even blow soon.
Old Faithful, yeah. Ain't that out west thing?
Yeah, out at Yellowstone Park.
Old Faithful.
They said... People were saying it might blow up within a couple weeks. They said it's 50 years overdue.
Yeah, because they say there's what there is. I've been monitoring my damn self. Earthquakes that's been happening in places that never happened before. All along the West Coast, the Midwest, St. Louis area, Texas. All that area is shaking now.
They just there goes your hoe from last week.
Where?
Across the street.
Who's that?
Old girl from last week.
Your
what's up, baby?
Hoe.
Oh, that's adultery.
That's
shit.
Adultery, yeah.
Shit.
Oh, she, man, bitch got about 15 niggas
now,
man.
I just fucking with her.
Between last week and now, man, she done picked up like 20 different, 30 different niggas already, man.
Adulterous ass, huh?
You know, ain't no shame in the game either. I'm gonna read this precept. You got more? What is?
Yeah, read the rest of that.
I wanted to read 13.
Go ahead, bring
go
it.
Go ahead,
up.
Go ahead, man. Cause I'm gonna read all the 13, man. I want to read all of it.
And the ways of it are troubled, and the fishes thereof also before the Lord and before the glory of his power. For strong is his right hand that bendeth the bow.
That bow.
Strong is his right hand, and too. Remember, Yahweh Shai sits at the right hand of the Father, too. Yahweh Shai going to bend that bow. Keep going.
His arrows that he shooteth are sharp and shall not miss.
Yeah, so when the missiles start shooting, the missiles ain't going to miss their target, man. Okay, they will not
shit.
Fail.
That's scripture.
What's that?
Keep going. That's scripture.
Yeah.
That's one of my favorite scriptures, too.
When they begin to be shot into the ends of the world.
Did you ask me for the scripture earlier that week? I just read that scripture to somebody earlier this week.
Which one?
That one right there. I was on YouTube teaching somebody. I can't remember. Y'all don't hear from me during the week. I be on YouTube and... I spend half my day dealing with trolls and people with questions.
Yeah.
There's always some asshole on our YouTube channel trolling the shit out of us.
Uh-huh.
And that usually take up an hour, half hour. You know what I'm saying? So we dedicate our life to teaching this truth, man.
Damn right, man.
So I enjoy it anyway. I enjoy trolling people. I troll the shit out of people on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
On Twitter, you know, wherever we at, we gonna troll your ass, man, with this truth.
Here you go. This is Joel 2:7. They show. I'm gonna start at 5. I'm gonna start up even more than that. Hold up. Man, I'm gonna start
Joel,
at 2.
Shit.
I'm gonna start at 2:1. Man, I'm gonna read all the way down to 8.
Then we gotta go to 3.
Joel 2:1. Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh.
So that's what we do. We telling y'all, you best to tremble. You better be scared. You know what I'm saying? Oh, you might have gone on Star Wars when Luke Skywalker said he wasn't scared. Yoda said, oh, you will be. You will be. You remember
right.
that shit?
Right, right. I'll be talking to these bitches, man. They talking about, we know the Lord's coming. We know he going to destroy a lot of things. But they don't have no fear in their heart. They don't really understand what comes with the with that destruction, you know?
Oh, you say the women?
Yeah, bitches talking about, I ain't scared. I ain't scared. They, I got the Lord with me, you know?
Yeah, a woman say she ain't scared is laughable.
Right.
They get scared of the goddamn... at a spider. They see a goddamn spider crawling. Ah!
Right. Hell, their man raises voice at them.
Yeah, they're called. She's called 911.
Man, they're fright. They pick up that phone. Damn right.
They'll actually, when they missiles hit, they'll try to call 911.
Yeah.
They're going to call the cops on the missiles.
Right.
They really try. Do you know when Facebook went down a couple weeks ago? Bitches was calling 911.
There was a panic. Yeah.
Facebook didn't work, so they called the cops.
Right.
What the fuck, man?
And people got locked up for that shit, too.
They deserve to get locked up for that shit.
Stupid-ass shit.
Call 911 because Facebook don't work.
People stupid, man. That just shows you the level of intelligence of you people. Stupid.
Very low.
Yep. For the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand. A day of darkness and of gloominess.
Yes, that's the day that's coming. Darkness and gloominess. Ain't gonna be no light.
A day of clouds and thick darkness, as the morning spread upon the mountains, a great people and strong there have not been ever the like, neither shall be any more after it, even to the years of many generations. A fire devoureth before them.
Right, that's them nuclear missiles.
And behind them a flame burneth. And the land is as the Garden of Eden before them, and behind them a desolate wilderness, yea, and nothing shall escape them.
Right, because that's what a missile, the thermonuclear missiles, it creates a desert. That's what it does. It destroys and disintegrates everything within its path. And what else could it be talking about? That's the only possible thing possibly be talking about.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? You get on that camera. He need to switch out. We can switch out. I know it's cold as fuck.
He said he did. The appearance of them is as the appearance of horses, and as horsemen so shall they run.
Right, because when that missile hits, when you see that fire will run. Once that missile hits, the cloud goes up, but at the base of it, the fire spreads out and it starts running. Mm. And it looks like horses running, like flaming horses running. And they running fast. That fire runs quickly.
That's right. You know, you watch them Western movies, you know, you might see some of them that have wild horses in the distance running.
Yeah.
And behind them, there's a smoke from the dust and shit.
Oh, yep. That's true.
And it's a roar. You can actually hear them from a distance. It's a deep sound of them running, man. It's a beautiful sound, actually.
It is, too, man.
It's beautiful to hear. It's that power. Where am I at?
That's where you get horsepower.
Yep, horsepower. Like the noise of chariots on the top of mountains shall they leap.
Right, that's talking about the missiles. I mean, that fire, too, that it just leaps. That fire just leaps, man.
Ooh, it's coming.
Because that fire, when that fire comes through, it goes straight up the wall, in the window. It destroys everything.
Ooh, God, damn. Like the noise of a flame of fire that devours the stubble, as a strong people set in battle array.
That's funny too, like when you look that up in Hebrew and it talks about how the fire devours, when you look that word devour up, it says it eats a call. The fire just eats everything in its path.
That sounds deadly. That sounds just vicious. That ain't no soft language either.
No. The fire gonna eat, it's gonna consume, devour everything in its path.
Mm-hmm. Hold up. Okay,
we should do like get one of them big ass oil drums with some fire while we take
them. Ah, right. Imagine
you
the fun.
Brother, you singing those songs?
I can imagine the fun.
Oh, yeah.
Before their face, the people shall be much pain. All faces shall gather blackness.
Oh, yeah, it's gonna be much pain. Because if your ass ain't been destroyed yet by that point, you're gonna be wishing you was destroyed.
Wee.
You ain't gonna know what to think.
Uh-huh.
We already gonna know what time it is.
Uh-huh.
We gonna know our the salvation is near on that day.
Yep. Wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy tongue.
When we see those missiles drop, we know what time it is.
Yep.
We ain't gonna be scared.
Hell, before the missiles stop.
We might cry. We might have tears of joy streaming down our face.
Yeah, when that chaos starts, yeah. Hell yeah. that's when we're going to actually be, you know, all that stress is actually going to be lifted off of us in a way.
Yeah, no, definitely. We're lifted.
Because we know it's what's coming behind after that.
That's a, like James Brown said, that's a big payback.
Damn right. Damn, should have drowned somebody.
Shit.
They shall run like mighty men. They shall climb the wall like men of war.
That's that missiles and that fire.
And they shall march everyone on his way, and they shall not break their ranks.
Right, so that fire and those missiles is not gonna break their ranks, man. They just keep going. Like you see like the Spartans with their wall of shield just marching forward, not stopping. That's how that fire is gonna be, bro. The phalanx of fire.
It's coming. Neither shall one thrust another. They shall walk everyone in his path, and when they fall upon the sword, they shall not be wounded. They shall run to and fro in the city. They shall run upon the wall. They shall climb up upon the houses. They shall enter in at the windows like a thief. The earth shall quake before them.
Right, that's that fire, man. And the earth is going to quake. Because when all these damn missiles start hitting the earth is going to shake.
Ooh.
It's going to rock back and forth like a drunkard.
Mm-hmm.
What's that, Isaiah?
Yep. The heavens shall tremble.
So the heavens, even the sky is going to tremble. The atmosphere is going to shake. You know what I'm saying? You're going to have so much smoke in the atmosphere.
The sun and the moon shall be dark, and the stars shall withdraw their shining.
Obviously, because there's going to be so much smoke, you ain't going to see shit.
Right.
It's going to be dark. It's going to be dark. It's going to stay dark for a long time.
And the Lord shall utter his voice before his army.
Right, because the Lord going to come out the heavens.
For his camp is very great, for he is strong that executed his word, for the day of the Lord is great and very terrible.
Yeah, the day of the Lord is terrible. Terror, that's where you get the word terror. So the Lord is a king of terrors, just like the book of Job says.
Yeah, yeah. And who can abide it? Let me get this.
Nobody abide it, man.
This is bad, man. How that scripture ended with the how the Lord is coming to do some killing.
Why you get? Well, you got something else?
Yeah, I'm
got
going right into that second Exodus 13.
All right, go ahead.
When the Lord coming through that. This is second Exodus 13:1 for all you Jesus lovers. And it came to pass after 7 days, I dreamed a dream. Let me blow my nose, man.
Man, it ain't no joke out here.
Yeah, it's bad, man. This is crazy, man. I'm trying to.
This is that cold, man.
I don't even
drink this. I don't drink no milk at all. Shit. I'll put some milk in my coffee every once in a while. Damn. Yeah, so the man, like you said, the day of the Lord is darkness and not light. This shit ain't gonna be no joke, man. All you scoffers out there, you people out there, you talking shit. You like to talk shit. You like to make fun of us. You're going to be destroyed. You're going to burn in that fire, man. Oh, we're going to laugh at you. It's going to be a good day.
Black conscious community.
Oh, them dudes are a joke. Did you watch that debate they had? I watched a little clip they put up. That shit was a goddamn joke. It looked like Showtime at the Apollo.
I didn't see the most recent one.
Like I said, it looked like Showtime at the Apollo. That shit was a joke.
Yeah, that's all it is.
I couldn't even watch it, bro. It was just noise. It was grievous noise. It was just, that's all I can say is noise. Just, I'd rather listen to pots and pans being banged together.
Yeah,
than hear
yeah,
that shit.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Or some East Indians in the background.
Right.
Doing what they do.
Harrison, I'd rather listen to Chinese music than hear that shit, man. That's what that shit sounded like, man. I'm trying to hear that bullshit, man. I couldn't even watch this shit. They had the clips. It was terrible.
Okay, here we go. This is 2nd Exodus 13:1. Okay, and it came to pass after 7 days, I dreamed a dream by night. And lo, there arose a wind from the sea, that it moved all the waves thereof. Can you hear me, Father?
Yeah, I got you. Yeah, it's loud.
And I beheld in lo that man waxed strong with the thousands of heaven.
That's some angels.
And when he turned his countenance to look, all the things trembled that were seen under him. And whensoever the voice went out of his mouth, all they burned that heard his voice, like as the earth filleth when it filleth the fire.
Damn. That goes back to, like we said, when the chariots come out of the sky and the Most High and the sun come out the clouds, that they're going to have destruction that you can't even fathom. You can't even conceive.
That's right. That's
destruction
right.
That you can't even, we can't even imagine what, how they'll destroy your ass.
That's right.
It'll just be like some, like I said, heavenly fire, destruction. You don't even know, man. They'll probably destroy your ass with a rainbow. I don't know what they'll do.
You know.
Some wild bugged out shit.
Yeah, because we talking about the Most High here.
Talking about the Most High.
That's right.
They got some bugged out.
Bugged out.
The Most High is bugged out, man.
That's right.
He's crazy. He's wild.
Mm-hmm. For real. And he got imagination for your ass.
He created the imagination.
Damn right. You're right. Created the imagination.
Can you imagine that?
Right, right. And after this, I beheld in lo, there was gathered together a multitude of men out of number from the four winds of the heaven to subdue the man that came out of the sea. But I beheld, and lo, he had graved himself a great mountain and flew up upon it. But I would have seen the region or place whereout the hill was graven, and I could not.
Oh, you talking, that's that giant spaceship, that starship, man.
Yeah, that's it.
That's that. I mean, this is talking about a big ass ship in the sky. He could compare. It was, the ship was so big, they likened it unto a mountain.
That's right, cause he, like you said, let me read it again. But I beheld, and lo, he had graved himself a great mountain and flew up upon it. Ezra's looking around like he's, where'd it come from? Who could have found it? And Ezra's bugged out. And flew up upon it, but I would have seen the region or place whereout the hill was graven.
Damn.
And I could not. And after this I beheld, and lo, all they which were gathered together to subdue him were sore afraid, yet durst fight.
You notice that this said the same thing as Revelation 12. When Revelation 12 said Satan and his angels fought against the Most High, Yahweh Shai and the angels. So when the Lord come out of the sky with all the angels and chariots, these devils, Esau, and all the governments, they're going to try to fight the angels.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous, man.
Yeah, it's going to be some amazing shit to see them motherfucking U.S. Air Force dropping out of this. Well, all these fucking earth, all the governments of the world, all their militaries going to be out there. That's why the Most High is gathering all these motherfuckers toward that area in the Middle East. That's why everything's focused on that area in the Middle East.
That's why Obama's saying they better go back to war right now over there. And,
that's right.
They're going to go battle ISIS.
He just sent something to Congress about authorization for or funding for whatever, man.
Fighting ISIS.
Fighting
supposedly.
ISIS. Right.
Well, there's more to it than that, man.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shit, I'm just cool with it, man. You go with that camera?
Okay, 9. And lo, as he saw the violence of the multitude that came, he neither lifted up his hand, nor held sword, nor any instrument of war, but only I saw that he sent out of his mouth as it had been a blast of fire.
Blast of fire.
And out of his lips a flaming breath. And out of his tongue he cast out sparks and tempests.
All right, that's an unimaginable destruction.
And they were all mixed together. The blast of fire, the flaming breath, and the great tempest. And fell with violence.
A great tempest. That's a fiery storm.
And fell with violence upon the multitude which were prepared to fight, and burned them up, every one.
Yes, yeah, sir. Any of you fools, you fighting against the Most High, literally or spiritually, you're going to get burnt the fuck up, man.
Damn fucking right.
Because you can't fight the spirit. You can't fight against the Most High. That's a battle that you can't win. You know what I'm saying?
It fell with violence upon the multitude which was prepared to fight and burn them up, every one, so that upon a sudden of an innumerable multitude, nothing was to be perceived but only dust. That's what the scripture he was reading.
Oh, yeah.
But only dust.
Because that scripture he read was talking about, he's going to beat you heathens to powder.
And that's that powder, that dust. But only dust and smell of smoke.
Smell of smoke. Hey, that's hell right there. Sulfur. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You was almost talking about hell. That's hell. That destruction, that's hellfire. That's Gehenna right there.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? That's Hades. That's the abode of the underworld.
When I saw this, I was afraid. Afterward, I saw that same man come down from the mountain and call upon him another peaceful multitude.
That goes into the 13.
That was it on that.
That goes into the lost tribes of Israel.
I got heat up for a minute.
All right, I got you. And look, and after all that destruction comes and all that, and while that's going on, this is going to happen. Let me break this out. Revelation 18:1. And after these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven. The angel's coming down from heaven. That means out the sky in a chariot, the so-called UFO. And after these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power. And the earth was lightened with his glory. That's why they call a chariot of fire. Hey, bright, it's gonna light up the whole sky. There's gonna be legions of them. And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the Great is fallen, is fallen.
America.
That's America. And it's become the habitation of devils and the hold of every foul spirit and cage of every unclean and hateful bird. For all nations had drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication, and the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her, and the merchants of the earth are waxed rich through the abundance of her delicacies. And this is the point right here. It says, I heard another voice from heaven. It's from the heavens up in the sky. You know what I'm saying? It's some chariots. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues. For her sins have reached unto heaven. I mean, the sins of America have reached unto heaven. And God hath remembered her iniquities. So come out of her, people. A lot of people read that scripture, they'll say that means you gotta come out of America spiritually, stop following the ways of America. No, it don't. Come out of her, my people, means to literally come out of her. It said, I heard a voice from heaven saying, come out of her. Mm-hmm. I mean, the angel coming out of heaven was going to beam us up like Scotty. Because I was watching Pastor Dal on YouTube. He always quotes this scripture, because Pastor Dal, if y'all don't know who he is, just look up Pastor Dal on YouTube. He's bugged out of his goddamn mind. He's a new Jim Jones. But he's got all these people tricked. He's got them all mesmerized in a hypnotic state, in a hypnotic trance, and he tricked all these people to come move out in the middle of the goddamn wilderness and build a community and shit. You know what I'm saying? And he uses this scripture right here. See, it says, come out of my people. That means to come out of those cities that you in. And come out, you know what I'm saying? So this dude don't know the scriptures, man. This scripture right here is talking about the angels coming out the heavens, beaming us up and taking us off of this goddamn planet. That's what that's talking about. Saving us from that fire and saving us from that destruction. That's what that's talking about. It ain't talking about nothing else. It clearly says a voice came out of heaven and said, come out of her, my people. Let me read. Is there more to this? Reward her even as she rewarded you, and double unto her, double according to her works. And the cup which she had filled her double. Right, so Esau gonna get double. Ah, shit. How much she hath glorified herself and lived deliciously, so much torment and sorrow give her, for she saith in her heart, I sit a queen and am no widow and shall see no sorrow. Because America's likened unto a woman, right? That's why you got the Statue of Liberty. More like a transvestite woman.
You're right.
But America's likened unto a woman. Okay? Even though most countries are likened unto a woman, even Israel is likened unto a woman. Just like boats are likened unto a woman. Cars. Ah, shit. I'll go ahead and bring it out, bro. I'm gonna start tap dancing so my toes will warm up.
Revelation 11 and 18. And the nations were angry, and thy wrath is come, and the time of the dead, that they shall be judged, and that thou should give reward unto thy servants, the prophets,
that's right,
and to the saints, and them that fear thy name, small and great.
That can only be the ones that's out here doing the work.
And them that fear the name, Yahweh Shai.
Right.
Okay?
Not Jesus.
Not calling on Jesus. Anybody can call on Jesus. I mean, right. That don't take no kind of spirit.
What the wicked's calling on, you know?
I mean, Jesus is a Greek title. It's not the Lord's actual Hebrew name.
Nor his nationality.
Nope. Yeah, the Lord wasn't no Greek. You know, that's what they called him in Greek. If we know the Lord's Hebrew name, you're going to call it his Hebrew name. You know what I'm saying? Which is Yahweh Shai. Mm-hmm. We're going to call the Most High Yahweh. We ain't going to call him Yahweh, Yoveh, or all this other nonsense, man.
Jezreel Bolger.
Oh, shit. Calling God, and that's Lord God.
God!
Say the Lord's name in vain.
right.
People are like, but that name Jesus got power.
Yeah.
I'll go ahead. You got more to that?
It should have destroyed them which destroyed the earth.
Oh, yeah, they destroyed them to destroy the earth. That's why these devils, they go around the earth, they polluting the earth, causing all this pollution. They engage in geoengineering. They spraying chemtrails all up in the sky. I heard the latest conspiracy theory. Before they said they were spraying us with aluminum, barium. Now they said they spraying sulfur in the sky.
How else can you explain? Remember the snow that we couldn't melt?
Oh yeah, the last year we had that chemical snow. It was famous. Everybody was making videos on YouTube.
Even 2/3.
That snow, you couldn't burn. The snow wouldn't melt. And it smelled like chemicals when you burn it.
Like burnt rubber. Yeah.
Burnt rubber. Yeah, it was weird, man. It was some weird shit.
Because I used to smoke the tires on my motorcycle. Just sit there and let those tires spin while you're just sitting there, and that smelled exactly the same way.
Yeah, that shit was foul.
Yeah.
That's why you see they got all these nuclear plants and shit. They taking on that nuclear radiation, burying it in the earth. They just creating all kind of waste, man. You look at the side of the river. Let me see you go take a drink out of it. You're going to drop dead.
Oh, hell yeah.
Let's see you go take a drink out the Hudson River.
You might start glowing.
Yeah, you're going to drop dead.
All right, I got to switch.
Yeah, go. We got a camera for a minute.
You might walk around looking like you Dragon Ball Z glowing and shit, powering up.
You're going to do the Kamehameha.
Right.
Going Super Saiyan 4 or whatever.
I get somebody $50. I swear they go drink out that side of it, man.
You going to... You ain't got to pay them.
Yep.
Because they going to drop dead.
Right.
Your daddy going to be in an emergency room.
What was that scripture you just read?
He was in Revelation.
Revelation. That was 17:11.
11.
Yeah, that was Revelation. Okay.
Man.
Drive the motherfuckers.
Damn.
This one of them days, that's hell on your hands, ain't it?
Shit, my motherfucking toes, boy. They feel like I got my... They feel like I got ice cubes for toes.
Damn.
My hands are frozen. Both of my feet are frozen.
I'm trying to turn pages with my gloves on. I ain't got no choice. It's all right, though. The scripture's still coming now.
One of them days, boy.
Right.
There's a lot of y'all weak, man. Y'all want to go out in the cold. They won't go out unless it's a perfect day. Not too cold, not too hot.
Yeah.
And they want to go out in the summertime. It's too hot. I get dehydrated.
It's a hell of a burden on these motherfuckers, man.
Talking about, I go on the highways and the byways. It's like the modern day highways and byways is the internet. Nah, man. Not everybody got the internet. You think everybody has the internet? Ain't everybody got the internet, man. People think everybody got the internet. These homeless people ain't got no goddamn internet. They can hear the word too. You know what I'm saying? We talk to homeless people all the time.
All the time.
Everybody got to hear the word, man. But plus, a lot of people don't have the internet. Some people hate computers. You know what I'm saying? They like, I don't use that shit. That's just the devil. I've had people tell me that. You know what I mean? So when you come out here, you reach a wider audience. Even though no one's...
Apples first came out, they were $666.
Oh, yeah. Apples were $666. And the symbol of the apple of, you know, Macintosh was the apple with a bite taken out of it. Like the forbidden fruit from the Garden of Eden.
God damn.
Yeah. Steve Jobs was a big fucking weirdo. He said he was a Hindu or a Buddhist or some shit. Oh, what's that new CEO they got? He's a fucking homosexual. The Steve Jobs successor. He's a fucking admitted homosexual. Oh, and people, he came out of the closet. And everybody's like, you didn't have to do that. We already knew. You big faggot.
Right.
What's his name? Tim Cook. That's his name. Big faggot, man. Big flaming faggot. And Apple is the number one, I think it's the number one profiting company in the world. They just broke sales records for a company.
Damn. I won't doubt that. But I think I just seen that yesterday. A couple days ago, they just posted that shit on the internet.
Fuck.
Talking about that shit, how they profit. All them numbers is just basically shit they just typing up any fucking.
I don't use that Apple shit. Mm-hmm. I use Linux, son.
I mean, what the fuck they use Apple for? Video, is something on video games or some shit, man?
Actually, Windows still the king of video games. I don't play your goddamn video games. I don't know. My goddamn toes is frozen.
I can't read, man. I gotta warm my fingers up.
Put up your hands in your nuts. That's what I've been doing all day. Hey, man, you gotta do what works. I'm about to find some fire scriptures. Give me a second. I'm gonna try to get the scripture out. This shit ain't easy. The only thing that works, bro.
City on his way.
Oh shit.
Right, we're about to leave. I'll stay out here longer if I could, man. I'm freezing up, man. I'm fucking dying. This is ridiculous, man. But it's all right, though. We put that vibration out here that these motherfucking proud motherfuckers walk around with smiles on their faces. And now they got something going to think about just by hearing us out here, just by seeing us, man.
Yeah, because
they can't defeat us with wills and with knowledge. So they, you know, they relying on their. The spiritual demon Satan do something to get us up out of here, man. So they hoping this weather can get us up out of here and keep us out of here, you know. Fuck these motherfuckers, man.
Yeah, fuck these faggots.
Faggots, Ohio State butt guys. Fucking nation of homosexuals. Nation of fucking faggots.
Man, I'm gonna read this. I'm gonna read a parable.
That helps a little bit.
What? That's the only thing that works. I'm gonna get the parable of the wheat and the tares. Y'all know about that, right?
Oh yeah, that's my shit.
Cause that's what we out here to wake up Israel, man.
13.
Yeah. Well, I ain't gonna read it all. It's so long. But I wanted to bring this out because that's why we out here. Because when the Lord said He came out, you heard a voice out of heaven. That's He's calling up His elect. He's calling up the nation of Israel.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. And all that elect ain't gonna look like John Shaft.
Yeah, they're not
or
all
Wesley
gonna,
Snipes.
They're not all gonna be the same color.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be a great multitude of people.
Black, dark skinned niggas.
Yeah, you got some people actually believe that, man. They actually believe that Israel only come with one color. Okay. Hey, actually, let's get Luke 10. Let's get the Good Samaritan.
Okay.
You want me to get it?
I'll get it.
I'll go ahead. I'll just warm up for a minute. I'm going to read this. You get that. You can take your time with it. Matthew 13 and 31. Another parable put he forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is like to a grain of mustard seed, which a man took and sowed it in the field, which indeed is the least of all seeds, But when it is grown, it is the greatest among herbs and becometh a tree, so that the birds of the air come and lodge in the branches thereof. Another parable spake he unto them. The kingdom of heaven is like unto leaven, which a woman took and hid in three measures of a meal till the whole was leavened. Because people think, y'all out there, you ain't waking nobody up. You ain't doing nothing. All we got to do is wake up one person.
One.
That's it. The scriptures say the angels in heaven rejoice over one sinner that repents.
That's right.
Plus, we could wake up one person. That one person we wake up could be the Apostle John, as one of the great apostles in the reincarnation. He'll go wake up 1,000 people.
That's right, like a domino effect.
Right, a domino effect. People are like, oh, you ain't, y'all camp so small and nobody's following you. You out your goddamn mind. The word of the Lord don't go out void. Because like that old saying goes, the Lord works in mysterious ways.
That's right.
All these things spake Yahweh shine to the multitude in parables, and without a parable spake he not to them. The Lord was speaking in parables. He wanted you to speak straight. Do you know what I'm saying? We speak in parables because this truth ain't for everybody. Now, we speak in parables just to confuse you and boggle your brains. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
That it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, saying, I will open my mouth to parables, and I will utter things which have been kept secret from the foundation of the world. Then Yahweh Shai sent the multitude away and went into the house, and his disciples came unto him, saying, declare us the parable of the tares of the field. Let's go back to the wheat and the tares. And he answered and said unto them, he that soweth the good seed is the Son of Man. That's Yahweh Shai. The field is the world. So right now, the Lord got us out here planting his seeds. We out here farming right now, actually.
That's right.
We
shepherds.
We herding the sheep. Fuck. I'm about to put this on now.
Hey, we herding the wicked ones. Because like you said in the parables, to keep the wicked wicked, and keep your ass in the darkness, and we got and the sheep. We're separating goats from the sheep.
Yeah, separate the goats. That's what a shepherd does.
That's right.
You herd the sheep. And the Lord is the good shepherd.
That's right.
The field is the world. The good seed are the children of the kingdom. But the tares are the children of the wicked one. The children of Satan. So this goes towards the two-thirds of Israel. They're like tares. But then you got the Edomites too. They're tares. Well, they're goddamn heathens. They're the devil. Children of Satan. Okay?
Satan coming.
Huh?
I see Daryl coming.
Oh, that's Daryl?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
See me
the is that where?
See him right there? On the wall? Walking?
Oh, I do see him. Shit, man. He's been out here for... He just not showed up. Goddamn. It's all good. At least he out here.
Yeah, that's right.
It's sitting there for... Well, we came out early.
That's like, fuck this shit. Like you was talking about early.
I'm starting to warm up actually a little bit.
Motherfuckers ain't thinking about coming out here, man. Motherfuckers can't get their spirit on to come out and do this work, man.
He asked, where am I at? Okay. The tares are the children of that wicked one. The enemy that sold them is the devil. So you got a lot of our people who are liking under tares. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Because they falling after the ways of the devil, which is Esau. You got the spiritual demon Satan, but then the spiritual demon Satan got his own children as the Edomites.
Mm-hmm. When I was growing up, I was always around dark-skinned motherfuckers that you would think was brothers, but they was actually
so-called white people.
Yeah, because it was actually right, Edomites.
Like, you see them, like, them rich, pasty white people down. Wow, you see them a lot downtown. You go, they wearing them business coats, they just red as hell, they all faggots, blowing each other. Behind closed doors, you know
right,
what I'm saying?
Right.
They got a foul spirit on them.
Yeah.
What's up, homie?
Yeah,
for real.
We done froze out this motherfucker.
Yeah.
Now we good.
Well, the motherfuckers I grew up with, anyway, they always had foul spirits on them. It was always several of them around, you know, but they always thinking about doing foul shit. Always doing foul shit. Even when we was playing football, basketball, they were always awkward, you know? Jumping off the wrong foot. can't throw right.
Yeah, can't throw, you can't play, but can't dribble.
Even you watch them eat. their eat, the way they eat is foul.
Well, that's like the so-called Jew.
Mm-hmm.
The so-called, how many so-called Jews have you seen in the NBA beside the commissioner or the owner?
None.
Well, how the hell could they be the descendants of King David,
right,
the greatest warrior in the history of the earth, if these motherfuckers ain't got enough coordination to shoot a jump shot?
Right.
Don't make no goddamn sense.
They were awkward as hell. Even rapping.
Because it takes coordination to be a warrior.
Yeah. Hell fucking yeah, man.
It takes great coordination to throw a sling like that.
Yeah.
To hit a goddamn giant between the eyeballs with a rock.
Damn right.
That takes coordination.
Precision.
Right.
That's a precision.
Check it out. These Edomite niggas, they couldn't even, you know, you hear a song, you can rap a song with the lyrics. If it's playing,
yeah.
they couldn't even do that
can't
right.
Can't do it. Be all offbeat.
It'd be, yeah.
They can't catch a beat when they got the words.
Singing or rapping can't even do it right. Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's real, man. I still see one of them, man. He a tear, straight up tears, man. But dark skinned and everything, man. Straight up dark skin.
That's just the way all them congressmen and senators, man, they're all goddamn Edomites, man. You know what I'm saying? Just a bunch of foul, wicked spirits.
I actually, be honest, to keep it real, man, my mom's first shit she spit out when her, you know, her first act of adultery with my dad, that motherfucker might be a tater. My so-called oldest brother might be an actual terror.
Damn.
Because he got a foul. He fouled me. You got to see him, man. You got to talk to him, man. He is straight up.
That's why you can't judge everybody according to skin color. You got Luke 10? You got Luke 10? Who did you got?
No, I was in Mark 10.
Oh, I was about to get
Luke
10. That's the parable, the story of the Good Samaritan.
Yeah, that's crazy, too, because I remember when I was in middle school, you had, now these had to be Edomite niggas because they was going around with the collar around their neck.
All that gay shit.
Yeah, the spike boots and all that shit. So all reality, them niggas probably was Edomites.
Yeah, that's why you can't judge a book by its cover. Hey, let me get the rest of this real quick. It said, and therefore the tares are gathered and burned in the fire. So shall it be in the end of this world. This is the scripture I really wanted to get. It said, the Son of Man shall send forth his angels, and they shall gather out of his kingdom all things that offend and them which do iniquity.
Mm-hmm.
So that means they coming forth with his angels out the sky, just like we was talking about this before you got here. So that's when the angels come out of the sky, they gonna say, come out of her, my people. And then the Lord's just gonna start destroying shit, man. He gonna save his people, and he's going to, not all of it, he gonna save the elect of Israel. And all these heathens, and all these two-thirds, all these adulterers, whores, all you faggots, you all gonna get burned up, man. And the Son of Man shall send forth his angels, and they shall gather out of his kingdom all things that offend, and them which do iniquity, and shall cast them into a furnace of fire. They shall be wailing and gnashing of teeth. Then shall the righteous shine forth as the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Who hath ears, let him hear. That's some point on that one, man. That's what I really wanted to bring out. That's what you tares gonna get burned up, man. We got, you know where that's at? Luke 10, I think it's 20-something.
That's excruciating pain.
Let me see where you at. I think it's 23. Yeah, 23. Hold on, let me see. Hold on. Oh, it's actually even farther down than that. Next page. My fault. I know it's in 10. Oh yeah, 29. So this. This goes back into the wheat and the tares again, about who's your brother, who's not your brother, who's going to be saved, who's not going to be saved, okay?
This is Luke 10 and 28.
This is what we doing out here. This is a spiritual thing. Everything we doing is spiritual.
And he said unto him, thou hast answered right, this do, and thou shalt live.
Oh, no, start at 29.
That's where I am.
Okay.
He, willing to justify himself, said unto Yehoshua, and who is my neighbor? And Yehoshua answered.
Yeah, right, because somebody asked him a question. They said, who's my neighbor? Who's my neighbor? Who's my brother? Keep going.
And Yahweh Shai answered and said, a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell among thieves, which stripped him of raiment and wounded him and departed, leaving him half dead.
So the dude was like pretty much laying in a ditch about to die, right?
And by chance there came down a certain priest that way.
So imagine that you're laying in a ditch, you about to die. And then he said a priest came by, a Levi priest. Keep going.
Okay. And the chance there came down a certain priest that way. And when he saw him, he passed by on the other side.
So this was an Israelite laying in a ditch. And here it is, a Levi priest came by, a priest, and he didn't even help him.
That's all people.
He's supposed to be his brother.
All people.
That's supposed to be his brother, though, right?
Uh-huh, that's right.
They the same color, same nation, but he didn't help him. He kept going. Keep going.
Shit. And likewise, a Levite, when he was at the place, came and looked on him and passed by on the other side. But a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him.
Right, because so then a Samaritan stopped, and the Samaritan was a heathen. Well, people were like, oh, what, the northern tribes were in Samaria. But you can read in 2 Kings, the 17th chapter, and it tells you
This is fucking amazing, man. Okay. 34. And went to him. Here we go. Okay. I gotta start at 32 again. And likewise, a Levi, when he was at the place, came and looked on him and passed by on the other side. But a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him.
So here it is. Let me read something about the Samaritans. About Samaria, because originally it was the northern tribes possessed Samaria, the kingdom of Ephraim, right? But watch this. This is 2 Kings 17 and 26. Wherefore they spake to the king of Assyria, saying,
contract. Okay, that's a bad Bible, man. Hey, I'll tell you what, man. That Bible itself is proof that this truth is technology is for us.
Yeah.
Because that cadre Bible you download, and you can download the Apocrypha, you can download the coordinates in Hebrew, Greek, Latin.
Yeah.
That's a bad book, man.
Yeah.
That's a bad book, and man.
Let me get this out. 2 Kings 17 and 23. Actually, let me start at 24. That's the point. And the king of Assyria brought men from Babylon and from Cutha and from Ava and from Hamath and from Seraphim and placed them in the cities of Samaria instead of the children of Israel, and they possessed Samaria and dwelt in the cities thereof. So this Samaritan right here looked like a heathen, but we know through the Spirit he's an actual Israelite that got scattered among those heathens. So read that. I just wanted to bring that out. You know what I mean? To give you a little history behind Samaria.
Because it's proof that it had to be an Israelite. Because when these heathens go by here, that, you know, they don't even, you can speak to them, but they don't even acknowledge you right there, man. You just spoke to them.
Yep.
They totally ignoring you. So this man has to be an Israelite.
He had to be an Israelite.
Okay. 30. I'm gonna start at 33 again. 18. But a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him.
So Samaritan, right? And this dude looked like a heathen. So here it is, the dude's so-called own people, same skin color as him and everything, just kept passing by, didn't even help him.
Uh-huh.
That's why it reminds me. I told you a couple weeks ago that truck I was driving broke down.
Right, right.
And all kind of white people just kept passing me by. Nobody was helping me. And out of nowhere, two so-called black dudes from the tribe of Judah, a mailman and some big 6'8", big tall motherfucker.
Right.
White
people riding by and tell, oh, I don't know. That looks like the Craigslist killer.
So it was two brothers that stopped to help me, bro. But here it is. Like, I have so-called white people. I hate niggas.
Uh-huh.
They just hate niggas. But here it is, your ass, you broke down, and then two niggas stop and help you. Now, how stupid you gonna feel then? You know what I'm saying? But that's who your brother is. You
feel like a jackass.
You feel like a jackass. You need to commit suicide, man.
Right. 34, and went to him and bound up his wounds, pouring in oil and wine, and set him on his own beast, and brought him to an inn and took care of him.
So he went out of his way to save this dude, man.
Yep.
But this is really talking about us. Because we going to fall. One time, you're going to be in trouble, and you're going to need help. Just like all them,
what was it on that one?
Them false, just like them Egyptologists and all them false flagging Hebrew Israel, them black Hebrew Israelites. They say only Israelites only come with one color.
Them fake ass brothers, man. Them
but one time they gonna get in trouble, mm-hmm. and then some white boy gonna come and save your ass.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But you gonna be bleed. You sitting there bleeding to death, or your car's on fire. You can't escape. You can be like, get away from me, cracker. Just let me die. Uh-huh. You know what I mean? Here comes Satan. When the spirit come out strong, Satan come through.
Damn right.
But that's how it is. Because people be prejudiced and shit.
Yeah.
The Lord, he gonna fuck you up, man, with your pride.
Damn right.
But never know. The Lord will put the spirit on another nation at that particular time to help you out with something.
Yeah. Yeah, even though I hate goddamn Jews. What if a motherfucker Jew helped me? You know what I'm saying?
You're
gonna take their help. But it could really be an Israelite, though, that was scattered. You know what I'm saying?
Holding your nose near the motherfucker the whole time, though.
Because a real Edomite ain't gonna help you, man.
No. He don't feel compassion.
Yeah, a real Edomite ain't gonna. He got no compassion. No, what's that called? An empathy. He got no empathy. You know, he's just straight cold. A cold-blooded serpent, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
A straight cold-blooded serpent. Just like a goddamn a Somalian ain't gonna help your ass unless he an Israelite. Because there's some foul people right there for your ass, man. A goddamn Somalian. You ever see a Somalian help somebody?
Oh, man, I broke I ripped my clutch on my motorcycle going down, you know, Westville Road, man. And, you know, you can't ride a motorcycle without a fucking clutch.
Nah.
Ham got a car lot right where I broke down at, and they was just about to close the lot down. They was closing the gate. I couldn't ride my motorcycle, so I had to leave it there till the next day so I could tow it.
Yeah.
I asked the ham mic, and it was ham.
Yeah,
I asked, motherfucking, look.
Fucking asshole.
Right, can I leave my bike here till the morning, man? Nah.
This ham got serious.
I was like, man, I can't ride my bike. I can't leave it right here on the street. Can I leave my bike right here? It's not bothering. I was breaking it down to the motherfucker, you know.
This ham hates Judah, bro.
Oh, man. He like, nah. He was rude. Yeah. Nah, nah.
Yeah.
And right across the street, this white dude had another used car lot. I want to ask dude, he was like, man, bring your bike here, man.
Yeah, that's some hospitality, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Man.
Right, man.
That's what Jake would do. Jake come through for you. He, you know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah. It was actually, the dude was obviously a Jake.
Gotta be.
Hell yeah, who's a Jake?
That's that good Samaritan right there.
Motherfucker Ham, I talking about we all brothers. No, we ain't, motherfucker.
That's how we know who our brothers are, man.
Damn right.
So I was the one who does the will of the Father that's in heaven. That's who's going to be getting beamed up out of here.
I ain't going to never forget that wicked shit, man.
But he going to get rewarded for that. Because Lord said, whoever gave me a drink, my brother a drink of water, gave me a drink of water.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So if you helped out one of the prophets, or the apostles, the Lord you're going to be rewarded for that, man.
Yeah, that's what we, man, we brothers, man. We help each other out, man.
Right.
I know this too.
Always let
it
know.
Goddamn Ham mites will fucking insert predicaments to make it seem like they're the same as us, so they can take credit for the struggle.
Right.
Oh yeah, take credit for the struggle.
Yeah,
even though you still got Israelites that look like them Africans. But you know a goddamn Ham mite when you see a Ham mite. There's no mistake in that spirit. That's a foul spirit, bro.
Off like a mug.
Hey,
quiet as cat, man. Bobby Christina Brown, the bitch about to drop dead.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That nigga, her boyfriend, that's a stare, man.
For real?
You can tell by looking at him. He either looked like an
Emma. He's a foster child,
Jew, or he looked like he got the spirit of them fake-ass Jews, or...
Whose daughter is it?
Whitney Houston's daughter.
From who?
She's about to drop dead.
With Bobby Brown?
Yeah. Christina Brown. Bobby Christina Brown.
But who'd you say was a Hamite? Or a
Jew? He's a He got the spirit of them East Indians or them fake Jews, man.
Her husband?
Yeah, yeah. Oh. It ain't her husband. They ain't really married.
And her
It ain't really her.
Okay.
He's not really, he was a foster child.
It is. He just took him off. They took him in.
I thought you were saying Bobby Brown.
Man, that ain't a Jake, man. That is not a fucking brother, man.
Christina Bobby Brown.
Okay.
It's Bobby Christina Brown.
First, I thought you were trying to say Bobby Brown was a terror.
Yeah, it's Bobby. Her name is Bobby Christina Brown.
It's Bobby Brown. That's an Israelite boy.
Yeah, that motherfucker, man, he is not a Jake. He is not a brother, man.
Yep.
He's a terror, man.
You see a lot of that, man.
Yeah, he tried to kill that bitch, man. They found her. When she found her, man, she said when they called 911, she was face down in the tub.
Right,
man.
Yeah, floating.
What's that all about? There must be some kind of some shit going down. Because they already said they killed Whitney Houston's ass. That's what she get for being in love with them Jews, man. God, they, you know she frozen.
God, them thick-ass thighs ain't froze.
Oh, yeah, they got some meat on them bones, boy.
You see how thick she was, man? Her mother's coat was like a skirt. Gotta be cute, though, man. That's a dumbass woman. That's a Thanksgiving dinner right there. Hell yeah. That's a dumbass woman. They gotta be cute, man.
We don't celebrate Thanksgiving, you know what I'm saying? That's just a joke.
That's
what I'm saying.
When y'all get a chance to pull up pictures on that motherfucker or her boyfriend, man, and just look at his eyes, man, you can tell he ain't a brother, man. That's a foul fish spirit on it. And plus the dude he was with when they called 911, he was a fucking Edomite. Jake don't hang out with Edomites like that, man.
Not unless they get money.
And it's his best friend, too.
Not unless you're like a Will Smith or
something. Yeah, the Edomite is his best friend,
but, too. But Whitney Houston was always in, hanging out with that, what's that big-time Jew motherfucker? They all, he's the one that discovered her or something, wasn't it?
I don't know if I discovered, but Whitney knew she was an Israelite and everything, man.
Yeah.
And it was some Jew that he had a vision out for that bitch because she wouldn't shake his hand. It was some fake ass Jew reached out to shake her hand. She wouldn't shake his hand because she knew she was an Israelite. She's like, I ain't shake that
bitch. That bitch could sing her ass off. Oh, man, that God bitch, damn.
Yeah, man.
She had something on
that's
YouTube.
That's a rare voice, too.
That's like when you
see. She used to be hot too at one time.
Yeah, back in the day.
Yeah, she was hot. Man.
That's why when you watch that raggedy ass Super Bowl, ain't nobody sang the national anthem better than Whitney Houston. Even though the national anthem's bullshit, but you're just supposed to be like the greatest song, the hardest song to sing. You know what I'm saying? And ain't nobody sang that shit like Whitney. You know what I'm saying? They should just have Whitney's on recording when they play that shit. You hear that? Man, that shit is weak, man. Y'all frozen enough?
Hey, it's gonna be hot when them nukes come off.
Yeah, them nukes are gonna
it's
come.
It's gonna heat
boy.
Up when them nukes come shooting. It's gonna get bright and everything.
Yeah, it need to. I'm tired of watching these motherfuckers.
Yeah, I know you're
saying women walking around
you,
here.
You see that nuke go off in Ukraine?
Nuke went off in Ukraine.
You gotta watch the video, man.
Oh man, you ain't seen that video.
Watch the video, bro.
All you gotta get on YouTube and just type in Ukraine explosion.
Yep.
Ukraine explosion.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
And they'll try to say a chemical plant blew up. It's a goddamn mushroom cloud.
It's fucking beautiful.
Oh yeah, I gotta see that shit.
It's beautiful.
They got it. Actual.
Yeah.
It was on RT.
There's one on RT. There's a bunch of different ones.
It's fucking beautiful, man.
Oh yeah.
It's fucking beautiful. That shit's heating up. It's heating up, man. It's coming.
He says heating up. Literally. It's literally heating up.
Damn right.
Because they just got out in peace talks today with Russia. Because Russia went up, they was pretty much threatening to annihilate every goddamn buddy.
Damn right.
They say, we're going to nuke all you motherfuckers, man. If you don't back the fuck off.
The Russians want to go to war, man. They
do.
They want to go to war. Against, they hate the U.S., man.
I hate it, too.
Hell, real. They hate this place, man.
Test those missiles.
Damn right. And they got some missiles. They even got a new missile that's supposed to be replacing the Satan missile.
That's supposed to be.
And you know that Satan missile is the largest nuclear missile that's ever been built.
They actually got a missile called Satan.
And they got a new one coming out that's replacing it.
That's a sense of humor for you.
Yeah, that is a sense of humor, bro. Because Satan, that's for the great Satan.
That's right.
Oh, that shit's gone, ain't it?
That's right.
That's good. It's still going.
That's still going. How much time has that got? Well, we about frozen anyway. Yeah. So we about to get up out of here. What's up? You got a ride?
Yeah, yeah.
Because we froze to death. No, just turn this off.